I've been working on these urns, or large vases, depending on how healthy you're feeling. And I thought I'd make one more just to show you how. This is about, I don't know, 7-8 pounds of clay. And I'm going to put it in the middle of the wheel. And it's going to turn into an urn. I'm going to center it this way just by squeezing it between the heels of my hand. A bigger piece, you got to bowl work it a bit more. I'm going to cone it up a bit and bend it over. And one more. It's getting better. I can get rid of this excess here. It just bugs me and it gives me a bigger place to keep my needle. One more pull up. That's feeling better. And I'm going to go my regular centering. And I want to center this with a narrower base, about the base of the vase. You don't want a fat center for a thin vase. Makes sense, doesn't it? And so I want a taller, thinner center. And that's pretty good. And I'm going to open this up. Now, I was watching a while ago. I haven't done this until I made those, and I was going to say I knew how, but I do know how, I just learned. Anyway, I haven't done this since I've never done this until I made these vases, but I'm going to open with my fist, and open it a little bit with my hand here, and then I'm just going to go down, and my knuckle's going to be sort of like the drill bit, and I'm just going to go straight down in there, and it works really nicely. And you can see it just goes down there and it opens it up. I am connected here with my thumb. I don't have a lot of feeling from where I am at the end of my knuckle. My fingertips are much more sensitive to depth, so I'm watching it a little bit closely. There we are. Then I'm going to flatten that out with my fist a bit. And I'm going to put my hands in. Now I'm going to go to my regular method of opening, of pulling my finger, my right fingers to the palm of my left hand. Actually, I'm using my knuckle. I lied. I'm using this. I'll do one more. I just want to open up the bottom. Now I'm going to switch, and my hands are going to go the other way. And now I'm pulling my fingers are right across from each other, and I'm just pulling across. My outside hand is raising up. My inside hand is still going across the bottom. I'm going to go down there and make it tidy. Now I'm going to pull it up. Notice I'm not going really fast. I was going faster when I was centering, letting the wheel do most of the work, but I want a little more control now, so I'm going a little more slowly. I'm going to bring that in. Not going to let it get very big. And pull it up again. I always make sure it's slidey and tidy. Finger pressures are directly across from each other. I got a hold of that clay and I'm pulling it straight up. See, sometimes it gets a little awkward at the top to keep pulling if your arms aren't long enough. You can at this point just cuddle it in and pull up. Anytime you push in, you have to pull up. You have to give your clay somewhere to go. You can't just push it in. It has to go up as well. And I'm going to go down there and get some more clay. And when you first start throwing tall cylinders, when I was teaching kids or adults, just breathe. Sometimes the people start throwing cylinder, they're breathing in and breathing in, breathing in, breathing in. And if you get a really tall cylinder, you don't breathe in, you could fall over and wreck your cylinder. But just breathe. There we go. So we're gonna pull up again. And I'm gonna bring that in. Oh, I got a messy bottom. I'm gonna go in there and tidy it up first. And I'm gonna keep that in. You wanna keep the top in. You don't want it to get away from you. It's really hard to bring it in again once it goes out. And if it's okay, if it's fairly thick, it's gonna get thinner as you keep pulling. Okay, so I'm gonna start giving this guy some shape. Now my fingertips are right across from each other. And I'm gonna pull up. And I'm gonna keep that guy in and not worry about the thickness right now. You have to be big enough to get your arm in there though. And pull it out a little bit more. One more, I think. That's better. Now I'm going to cuddle it in, clean up my bottom. Cuddle it in. And at this point, if your pot has a little bit of rhythm, don't worry about it. So it says some of my favorite people have a little bit or a lot of rhythm. So don't worry about it. Pots are like people. There's very few perfect people, and there's very few perfect pots. So. I'm going to do what I call my six-point cuddling. Because it's 2, 4, 6, and it just sounds so cute. I don't get it much. Anyway, this is where the top quite often finds rhythm at this part of the process, and I don't care. I'm just gonna now cut that out, get rid of it. I'm gonna look at my shape. It's kind of like the rest of them, I think. Now I'm supporting that and I'm right underneath, you can maybe see where my hands are dirty. I was right underneath that shoulder and supporting right underneath it on top. So I'm holding it from both sides, giving it some definition and pulling up that top. Gonna have a look at my shape. Now you don't want this part to get too tall, because I'm going to throw a bowl upside down for a lid in a minute, and this part is really tall, it's hard to get your bowl to fit. But I'm not going to worry too much about sponging it and making it tidy, because I'm going to mess with it as I make the bowl fit on top. I also notice that it's slightly tapered, so the bowl will fit over top. If it's shaped this way, you're going to have a problem getting your lid on there. And the inside is tidy. I'm going to get rid of that. Outside, a little definition right there. Tidy my taper and cut it level. And I'll sponge it off just because I have to. It's just who I am. It's pretty much done. I do have quite a bit of clay right here. I'm gonna get rid of that clay right there. Going to undercut it. If you have a problem with it peeling, you can, as I said before, just put a little bit of water in there and chase that around. But this guy's going to peel. This guy, well, now it's, the water made a mess. This guy's going to peel fine. Very appealing, this little pot. And I got a good place to keep my needle. I'm going to, that was rude. I'm going to throw my wire on the floor, pick it up, tidy it off. I'll cut this off and I'll make a lid for it and talk about trimming in a bit.